you want to use for fetching the token, right? So this is a host size, means your application name, and this guy's gateway port, right? So it's our token. An authorization, I put basic authentication, okay. Then guys, here you need to use this thing. Then ready. It's an internal server error, so we need to look on it. Here you can see there is no password map for ID null. This is the issue, because he can use another, like this, right? You can use another password encoder. So shall we try this? It is idiot. 2, 3. I think the problem is encrypting, I think, I believe. So can use. This need is I think sometimes this may be the issue. I'm not sure this is spelling is correct, so we'll see. Try one more time. Internal server requires. Fortunately, we can get the token time. So tiny. Okay. Till now we are fine. So we fetch the token and this is our request token, and this is our username. Our first thing, right? Good. So then now token is we can fetch our token. So next step is, guys, so we need to create the proper Angular application for initializing the login part, as well as pre-authorization. We can put permission, right? So that's what we need to do in next couple of videos. So also, guys, so in here we set only a static port inside authentication. So we need to implement in a different way, like we need to get the authority dynamically, right? So for this purpose, we need to implement more table, like role feature and role feature mapping. View more mapping, we need to initialize all that. So let's start those things. So next, after that's this implementation, we can move this front end implementation, right? So in Angular 3, I'm expecting to develop a front end Angular application. So this is very basic thing. So let's see how we can do.